Hi, I'm Ms. Hearn. Let's get started. In this video, we're going to explore more about the power of a normal distribution. And in particular, we're going to use a cumulative Z table to solve applications. There's a few things we're going to need to know in order to achieve the goal of using a Z table to find areas. We're going to need to know how to calculate Z scores. We're going to need to understand the type of Z table that we're using, and then we're going to need to practice drawing a normal curve that represents a given scenario. A Z score is the number of standard deviations between the mean and a given data value. You can calculate a Z score using either of these formulas. Both of these formulas really mean the same thing. A Z score is equal to the data value minus the mean divided by a standard deviation. Let's see if you remember which one of these formulas represents the population z-score, because it includes symbols for the population mean and the population standard deviation. If you said A, you're correct. In a population, we use the Greek letters mu and sigma to represent mean and standard deviation, whereas in a sample, we use X bar and S. So let's practice plugging into this formula. Given a mean of 12 and a standard deviation of 3, find the z-score for a data value of 18.25 to 2 decimal places. Go ahead and pause the video and check to make sure you know how to do this on your calculator. If you said 2.08, you're correct. To plug in, we would have 18.25 minus 12 divided by 3 equals 2.08. Make sure that you do the subtraction in the top of the fraction bar first before dividing. Now, what would we use this value for? Well, let's say that we had a normal distribution and we knew the mean was 12 and we're interested in a data value 18.25. Maybe we're interested in how much data is less than that or how much data is more than that. Either way, what we're going to do is we're going to convert it to its z-score. The z-score of the mean is always 0, and we already found that the z-score for 18.25 in this scenario is 2.08 using our z-score formula. In order to get one step closer to figuring out how much data is below or above 18.25, we would need to use a z-table. A z-table is just a chart that gives you a list of z-scores and an area associated with those z-scores, but which area depends on the type of table you're looking at. For example, a z-score of 1.13 is associated with an area of 0.371. But what does that represent? Well, if we're looking at a cumulative z-table, that would represent all the area to the left of z. But if we're looking at a z-table that's cumulative from the mean, it's going to be the area between 0 and z. And if we're looking at a z-table that's complementary cumulative, it's going to be the area to the right of z. So it's very important to know which one you're looking at. In this video, we're going to look at a cumulative z table. So the areas that are listed in the table are going to represent the cumulative area to the left of z. So in our example, where we had a z score of 2.08, we're going to find 2.0, and across the top, we're going to get the second decimal place, which is 8. So that together makes 2.08. And then we're going to look across and down, and we're going to see that it's associated with an area of 0.9812. That area is the area to the left. And you can tell because on your table, you're going to have this little legend that shows you that it's shading to the left in blue there. So that's the area that they're giving you. In the problem we were discussing, we would know the area in white would be 0.9812. But what if we wanted the area to the right in gray there? Well, that's easy enough because we know the area under a standard normal curve is equal to 1. So we can just subtract that 0.9812 and we can see that the area in gray is 0.08188. It's often the case when you're using a cumulative z-table that you're going to subtract from 1 because you want the area on the other side. So let's look at an application. Tall Clubs International has a requirement that women must be at least 70 inches tall. Given that women have normally distributed heights with a mean of 63.8 inches and a standard deviation of 2.6 inches, find the percentage of women who satisfy the height requirement. So the first thing you always want to do when you're solving a problem like this is to draw a picture. If you skip that step, it may be confusing which area you're talking about, and you can make errors. So I'm going to draw the normal distribution with a mean of 63.8 and shade the region representing those data values that are above 70 inches to the right of 70 inches because the problem said at least 70 inches. So the data value we're interested in is 70 inches. We're going to have to convert that to a z-score to get information we need. So why don't you try it? Try to convert the data value 70 using the fact that the mean is 63.8 and sigma is 2.6 to find the z-score. You can pause the video and work it out. And if you got 2.38, you're correct. You take 70 minus 63.8, divide by 2.6, and you get 2.38. Remember, the subtraction has to happen before the division. All right, now we're going to go back to our problem and we're going to add to our diagram an extra number line underneath. But this one is a z-scale. It's a number line that shows the z-scores associated with the data values. So under the mean, we have a z-score of 0, and we just found that under 70, we have a z-score of 2.38. So the next thing we need to do is to look up z equals 2.38 on your z-table. Here's an enlarged picture. We're looking for 2.38. On this type of z-table, we have 2.3 on the side column, and we have to look for the 0.08 across the top. Looking across the 2.3 row and down the 0.08 column, we see that we have an area of 0.9913 associated with this z-score. Now that's the area to the left of our data value 70, but we're interested in the area to the right. So we're going to subtract from 1. 1 minus 0.9913 is 0.0087. Or if we want a percentage, move the decimal place 2 places to the right, we have 0.87% of women are over 70 inches tall. So to summarize the steps that we used in this problem, if we're given data values in a normal distribution and we want to find either the area, probability, or percent, we're first going to sketch a normal curve, label the mean and any specific x values, then shade the region representing the desired area or probability. For each of the relevant x values, that's a boundary for the shaded region, we're going to use the formula for the z-score. Then we're going to use a table to find the area of the shaded region, and that area gives you your desired probability or percent. Here are some tips to avoid errors. First, don't confuse the z-scores and the areas on the z-table. The z-scores are generally given as 2 decimal places, and the areas are generally given as 4 decimal places, so that might help you to distinguish between the two. Second, shade the correct side of the data value. For example, if the problem says more than, you're going to shade to the right, and if it says less than, you're going to shade to the left. 3, z-scores are going to be negative when they're located to the left of the mean. On our cumulative z-table, there's actually a separate page for negative z-scores, but you still look it up just the same way. And finally, just because z is less than the mean doesn't mean you're going to shade to the left, and just because z is to the right of the mean doesn't mean you're going to shade to the right. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. That will help other students to find the video.